There was nothing about the starry sky that night to suggest that strange and mysterious things would soon be happening. As unsuspecting muggles slept, a huge motorbike with a giant astride it tumbled down from the darkness. The giant, named Hagrid, left a blanket-wrapped bundle on the doorstep of number 4 Privet Drive. Nestled in the bundle was a baby. Harry Potter, the boy who lived. For the next 11 years, Harry lived with his dreadful step-parents, the Dursleys. Until that fateful day, when he received the letter inviting him to attend Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. Hagrid took Harry to Diagonally to purchase a most unusual list of school supplies. While at Gringotts Wizard Bank, Hagrid collected a scruffy package from Vault 713, mentioning to Harry that the package, whatever it was, would be safer at Hogwarts. Soon after, Harry caught the Hogwarts Express from platform 9 3/4 and left the Muggle world far behind. Dumbledore stood up. "This term, the corridor on the third floor is out of bounds to everyone who does not wish to suffer a most painful death." Harry sat beneath the sorting hat, hoping that he would not be chosen for Slytherin House over Gryffindor. "Not Slytherin, eh?" said the hat in his ear. "You could be great. It's all here in your head, and Slytherin will help you on your way to greatness." "No? Well, if you're sure, better be..." "Gryffindor!"
Welcome to Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. I am Albus Dumbledore, your headmaster. Now, Hogwarts is full of secrets, Harry, so search behind every door. But keep in mind, not all secrets are rewarding. Only this morning, I took a wrong turn and stumbled upon a room full of chocolate frogs. But alas, when I returned, they'd been replaced by a nasty horde of fire crabs. Now, up the stairs and off to your lessons. Don't be late.
Hey, Harry! Remember me, Ron Weasley? My brothers, Fred and George, have something to show you. Follow me! Follow me, Harry!
"Hello, Harry. We can show you how to get around Hogwarts. As a first year, you have a lot to learn. Follow us for a secret lesson."
"I'll see you later in Defense Against the Dark Arts class. Good luck, Harry."
"We're going to teach you how to climb. Run to the bookcase and don't stop. You'll climb up. Above the bookcase is a Bertie Bott's Every Flavour Bean. Collect all the beans you can find and meet us in the next room." "Well done. Now, let's try jumping. Run to the ledge, then press the jump button to jump across. If you fall down, you can climb back up and start over. Meet us in the next room. We'll take the shortcut and meet you there."
"Whoa, it's Pottyway Potter!"
That was really close.
"Always causing trouble. Peeves doesn't like first years, so watch your step.
Young Potter, you're ugly, but what can we do?
You're getting the hang of this. In Hogwarts, you'll find all sorts of wicked treats. To pick up a treat, just run over to it. Chocolate frogs boost your energy. Bertie bots every flavor.
I didn't even pay attention. I forgot to skip the cutscene. Whatever. I'm not gonna be set over that.
Come back when you've got them all. Come see us, and we'll show you the way to class.
If I reset.
Talk to Fred. Thanks, Harry. We couldn't have done it without you. We need the beans for some experiments. Here's a wizard card for you. You've earned it. Climb through the secret exit above the bookcases to get to your first spell lesson. Good luck.
Isn't the famous Harry Potter. I'm Draco Malfoy, and you do well to show me respect.
These are my fellow Slytherins, Crabbe and Goyle. Naturally, we Slytherins are going to win the House Cup and the Quidditch Cup. You better stay out of our way, Potter. Let's go, boys.
Professor Quirrell, today we'll learn how to protect ourselves against dark magic with the Flipendo spell. Watch my wand, then hold down the mouse button and repeat the pattern. Release the button when you're done. Mr. Potter, 5 points for Gryffindor. And again, Mr. Potter, let's see what you can do. Rather disappointing, but at least you tried. Splendid! You may now enter the Flipendo Challenge to practice the spell. Follow me, Mr. Potter. Hold down the mouse button to aim the Flipendo spell. Release the button to cast the spell. Try it on that barrel.
Flipendo! Flipendo!
Cast your Flipendo spell at the switch on the wall to open the door. Flipendo affects all sorts of things, such as this cauldron. Knock it over, Mr. Potter.
Flipendo! Flipendo!
Well done.
That was really good.
Go on and collect your challenge stars. I'll meet you further on.
Oh.
Hello, Harry Potter. I am Nearly Headless Nick, the Gryffindor House Ghost. Now, this is a save game book. When you touch it, your game will automatically be saved. The game will restart from this point if you faint. You can also load a saved game from the main menu. Goodbye.
Flipendo! Flipendo!
Cast your Flipendo spell on this block to knock it out of the way.
Flipendo! 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 Flipendo!
This is a gnome, Mr. Potter. They like to pester young wizards. Knock him on his backside to complete the challenge. They move quickly and can be quite a nuisance. Congratulations, Mr. Potter. You completed the challenge. You collected the required number of challenge stars. 5 points for Gryffindor. Now, get to broomstick practice before you're late.
Back in their Gryffindor common room, Harry, Ron and Hermione talked about their exciting first days at Hogwarts. There was much talk about the break-in at Gringotts Wizard Bank. But there was little time to dwell on this, since Harry and his friends were expected at their flying lesson with Madame Hooch.
I am your instructor, Madame Hooch. For your first lesson, you will fly through these magic rings. The speed up and slow down keys adjust your flight speed. Ready, Potter? On my whistle, then. Well done, Mr. Potter. Now let's see how you do with smaller rings. Let's add a bit of height. These rings should challenge you. Let's try it with moving rings.
That was so bad, I don't even know how I saved time on that.
From now on, you may practice flying at any time.
I missed all three rings. Jesus.
Time for your charms lesson now. Good day, Mr. Potter.
You're early for the lesson, Harry, but I'll teach you a new spell I've learnt on my own. The spell I learned is Alohomora. It will open magically locked things, but don't get into any mischief. This is the symbol for Alohomora. When I stop, hold down the mouse button and make the same pattern. Then let go of the button.
You're a little stress. I was not prepared to start that.
Here we go,
this time.
I know you can get it right.
Alohomora!
That was good, but I know you can do even better. Great, Harry. I'm sure Professor Flitwick would give you 5 house points for that charm. You're getting the hang of this. What was that? Now you try using Alohomora. We still have a few minutes before the charms lesson. That door in front of you is magically locked. Cast Alohomora to open it. Try to close the door. We don't have all day. You've got it. Now, can you find the 2 secrets in this room?
Alohomora!
If you're done admiring yourself, Harry, take a look at that magical chest. Cast Alohomora to unlock it.
Alohomora! Alohomora!
Charms class is through this door.
I really learning this spell.
Welcome, young wizards. I am Professor Flitwick, and today you will learn the levitation spell Wingardium Leviosa. Observe the correct Wingardium Leviosa symbol. When I stop, hold down the mouse button and follow the pattern, then release the button. That's good for a first year, Mr. Potter. 5 points for Gryffindor. Try going slightly faster this time. An irregular version of the spell won't work, Mr. Potter. You may now enter the Wingardium Leviosa challenge to practice the spell. Follow me, Mr. Potter. Wingardium Leviosa on that statue, then move it onto that large plate.
Wingardium Leviosa!
Well done! Now go and collect the challenge stars. I'll meet you at the end. Good luck, Mr. Potter.
Wingardium Leviosa!
This game. Doesn't help that I'm very tired. There we go.
Congratulations.
I'm still happy with that.
Completed the challenge. You've collected the required number of challenge stars. 5 points for Gryffindor. Now, off you go.
Let's nail this one cycle. Wow.
Hey, Harry. Do you have 25 beans for us? We need the beans for some experiments.
I went the wrong way again.
Hello, Harry. I'm Neville Longbottom. This is my remember-all. It tells you if there's something you've forgotten to do. Oh, it's telling me we have herbology class soon. Oh, I almost forgot. Watch out for Draco Malfoy. I saw him sneaking around here just a moment ago. Have you tried a broomstick yet? I think I'm a bit scared of flying.
Well, Potter, we meet again. Having a tour of the castle, are we? This is as far as you'll be going. You won't get past me, no matter how hard you try. Oh, boo-hoo! Potter can't get out of the castle. These wizard crackers should make you feel better. They're surprisingly good fun. Here, catch!
That was stupid.
Curse you, Potter! Next time you
That was really bad. I probably lost like 15 seconds to that.
Hagrid, good to see you. These are the Hogwarts Castle grounds, and I'm the gamekeeper, of course.
can't believe how quickly everything grows round here. Your friend Hermione's at the entrance to the greenhouse waiting for you. Drop round for tea later, after your lessons are done.
The herbology lesson is just past Professor Sprout's garden. I'll wait here for Neville. I think he's got lost again. Go on, Harry. You better get to the lesson.
Welcome, class. I am Professor Sprout. Today we'll learn the incendio spell, which is useful against all manner of dangerous plants. Observe the correct incendio symbol. Hold down the mouse button and follow the pattern. Then release the button. Wizard, Mr. Potter. 5 points for Gryffindor. Let's continue with the lesson, Mr. Potter. An interesting variation on incendio, but unfortunately it's wrong. Now it's time for the incendio challenge. Through the doors, Mr. Potter. I'll watch you from the balcony. Those are spiky bushes. You may cast incendio on them, but step back to avoid their needles.
Incendio! Oh.
Incendio!
Flipendo! Flipendo! Flipendo!
This is a typical species of venomous tentacular. Cast incendio to wilt it.
Incendio!
Now collect the challenge stars to complete your lesson. Away you go.
Alohomora! Alohomora!
This game is dumb. I'm proud. Not a whole lot, but still quite a bit. 20 seconds.
Congratulations! You completed the challenge. You've collected the required number of challenge stars. 5 points for Gryffindor. Now off you go.
There you are. I hope you did well in your herbology class. I've got something I need to talk to you about. Be best to discuss it back at my hut. Meantime, you're gonna be late for your broomstick training. Off you go.
Here comes Neville. He looks quite upset. Best go and see what he wants.
Please help me.
So Longbottom has gone snivelling to you, and you want me to give you his precious Remembrall.
I think I'll leave it somewhere for Longbottom to collect.
How about up a tree? Think you can catch me? Come on then, Potter.
Give me back Neville's Remembrall, Malfoy.
You want the Remembrall back? See if you can catch it. And you better watch out for my bludgers!
That was really bad. That was so bad.
You damaged my broomstick, Potter! You'll pay for this. Here, take this stupid thing. I've no use for it.
You've got my remember all back. Thanks, Harry. I'll be able to find my toad now. Come here, Trevor.
Those bushes, though.
I remember now. I left Trevor near the herbology class. There are plants there that eat toads.
Mr. Potter, I'm Professor McGonagall, deputy headmistress of Hogwarts and head of Gryffindor House. Although I do not approve of your chasing Malfoy about, I'll admit you have remarkable talent on a broomstick. Ordinarily, first-year students may not compete in Quidditch. In your case, we might overlook that rule. Harry, Gryffindor's first Quidditch match of the year is later this afternoon against the formidable Slytherin team. See you then.
Over here. Come along then. I've something to show you, Mallard. By the way, congratulations on making the Quidditch team. Word travels fast round Hogwarts. Welcome to my home, Harry. It's small, but still roomier than your cupboard under the stairs, eh? Now I can show you what I wanted to talk to you about. It's a dragon's egg, Harry. But it's our secret, mind you. The egg is at a very delicate stage. I can't leave it here alone, but I need some fire seeds to give it that last burst of heat to make it hatch. Harry, can you fetch me some fire seeds? I grow them in caves out in the garden. I need you to collect as many fire seeds as you can find. Careful though, they're spitting fire and the seeds are hot. Let them cool down before you pick them up. Off you go then.
Flipendo!
Be a fire seed plant. Hagrid told me to stay away from the hot seeds.
Nimpendo!
Well, there goes all of my time.
Great work, Harry. You've collected all the fire seeds I need. Come on inside, Harry. Wipe your feet now. Go ahead and put them in the fire, Harry. You've done it, Harry. It's hatching. Ain't he lovely? I'll call him Norbert. He's a Norwegian ridgeback, you know. Up you come, me beauty. Thanks, Harry. Here, take this flute. It can be used to help some creatures sleep. You'd best get ready for Quidditch now. Should be an exciting game. Slytherin's a tough team, but you'll show 'em, eh? We'd better give Norbert his first feed soon.
Welcome to Quidditch! I'm your commentator Lee Jordan. It's Gryffindor versus Slytherin. The Quidditch pitch has three goals at each end. The chasers throw the Quaffle and try to put it through the hoops to score. Watch out for the bludgers. These are charm balls that can knock you off your broomstick. Two beaters of each team try to keep them away. Where? Gryffindor's new team seeker is Harry Potter. It's his job to find and catch the golden snitch.
Jordan, no favoritism.
Sorry, miss. Remember, first avoid the bludgers, then find and catch the snitch. The game is over when the snitch is caught. Good luck. Let's play Quidditch! Was that the snitch? Look at Potter go! He's after the snitch! Potter is so close! Wonderful! It's all done! Potter's done it! Gryffindor have beaten Slytherin! Well done, Harry Potter! My name's Lee Jordan, signing off!
I should probably change that split to when I actually catch the snitch.
Harry Potter, the youngest seeker in the history of Hogwarts, had won the Quidditch match.
Congratulations again for winning the Quidditch match against Slytherin. You are fantastic. Something is troubling me, Harry. Ron and I heard strange noises outside the Forbidden Corridor. Come up to the third floor and have a look.
Did you see that? Professor Snape just came out of the Forbidden Corridor. He's limping quite badly. Come on, Harry. Let's take a look before Filch comes back. Hear that growling? Oh, I think there's something awful down the corridor.
Better tell me on the run. We'll be late for our defense against dark arts lesson.
We'll learn to illuminate dark magic with the Lumos spell. Watch my wand. Then hold down the mouse button and repeat the pattern. Release the button when you're done.
Ooh, just barely. I was really lucky.
That was a shaky effort, Mr. Potter. Do practice.
5 points for Gryffindor. Try working faster this time, Mr. Potter. That's not it, Mr. Potter. You may begin the Lumos challenge to practice the spell. Follow me, Mr. Potter. Hold down the mouse button to aim the spell. To cast Lumos, let go of the button. You may practice on that gargoyle.
Lumos!
That's quite bright, isn't it? Now you can cross the chasm and collect your challenge stars. I'll meet you at the end.
Oh, that.
Oh.
Flipendo!
I think I'm lost.
I'm definitely. I might just work even. By that I mean like get minus zero. What am I talking about? I still have so much time left. I'm bad at this game. Oh no. I saved 34 seconds and I thought I was gonna lose time.
Points for Gryffindor. Now, hurry on to your potions list.
That's what my- The run was...
Next is our potions lesson, and it looks like we're already late.
I am your potions teacher, Professor Snape. Today, you will learn how to mix a Wiganweld healing potion. You're late for potions, Mr. Potter. Inexcusable, even for celebrities. 5 points from Gryffindor. Potter, go to the dungeons and fetch the potion ingredients for the class. Bring back Wigan tree bark, moly, dittany, and flubberworm mucus. Be quick about it, or I shall deduct house points from Gryffindor. Now be gone, and don't come back without the ingredients.
That must be dittany.
A snake tricked me.
Flipendo! 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 Flipendo!
Mortimani told me. I think that's the moment.
Flipendo!
It's the bloody Baron.
Let's see if I get glitch platforms. Oh, well, I did. That did waste a lot of time. I might as well try the super jump once. Got it. Wow. Except I missed the platform. Still got the super jump though.
Be dissonant.
Late again, you lazy boy. A further 3 points from Gryffindor should teach you a lesson. I see you've collected a few challenge stars, but I'm afraid
I need to pee really badly.
I've ended the lesson without you, Potter. The other students are off to the Halloween feast. Join them if you must.
ledge. It's cornered Hermione in the girls' toilets. She needs our help. We must try to rescue her straight away.
Well, we lost Ron.
Harry, what's that smell?
Missed one, sad face.
For saving me. Is he dead?
I think he's just been knocked out.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Exhausted from their encounter with the troll, Harry, Ron, and Hermione return to the Gryffindor common room and discuss the strange goings-on at Hogwarts. Harry suspected that someone had released the troll to distract everyone so that they could get into the Forbidden Corridor. There wasn't much time to think about who was behind this, especially since Harry was busy preparing for the second Quidditch match against Ravenclaw.
Up! Welcome to Quidditch! I'm your commentator, Lee Jordan!
So I'm gonna do the split when I catch the snitch.
My name's Lee Jordan, signing off.
Thanks to Harry's skill as a seeker, Gryffindor won the Quidditch match against Ravenclaw. Harry, Ron, and Hermione spent most of their free time in Hagrid's hut, trying to convince him that he couldn't keep Norbert, his beloved dragon. Eventually, after much coaxing, Hagrid agreed. Harry unwrapped the unexpected Christmas present. Something fluid and silvery slithered out. "It's an invisibility cloak," said Ron. "They're very rare." There was a note with the cloak. "Your father left this in my possession," Harry read. "Use it well. A very Merry Christmas to you." Harry tried on the cloak, while Ron and Hermione helped him prepare for the climb up the tower. "Be careful, Harry," said Hermione. "You can't stay invisible while you cast spells. Filch might see you." With Norbert safely bundled up, Harry set off for the tallest tower. He hoped that the cloak would conceal him from Filch and his cat, Mrs. Norris.
What's that?
I'm not gonna lie, I'm really bad at this party, so it could be a really bad spoiler. Plus, I still really need to pee.
Now, how can I get up there?
You sneaky slime! I'll catch you! Yes, I will!
What's that?
What's that? I tried to yellow it. I waited too long. If I'm gonna yellow it, I have to be quicker about that.
Now, how can I get up there?
And when I do, you'll regret it. Sneaky slime! I'll catch you! Yes, I will! Where is he? Pray I don't find you, my stealthy little student. Where are you, you snip? Where is he? Pray I don't find you, my stealthy little student.
Wrong. When I get to the top of the tower, I'm going to pee.
Do you think I'm blind? I'm not letting anyone into that tower tonight. Peeves, you'll be banished for this.
That could come in handy if I have to distract Filch along the way.
Ron's brother Charlie had arranged to collect the dragon from the tower and return him to Romania.
Mrs. Norris, I could have sworn I heard footsteps in here, but... Yeah, blah. Let's check the library, my sweet.
Ugh.
heard you for sure this time. Quick, Mrs. Norris, you keep watch from above. You'll not get past me now, you rotten little gutter snipes.
YOLO strat.
Bleh! Where is he? Pray I don't find you, my stealthy little student.
Wasting time like a boss.
Intruder!
Again, Harry. How's the bean collecting? Fred and George are up to their usual tricks, I presume. I heard about your Quidditch victory.
I want to get around 130 on this split.
Intruder! Intruder! In the forbidden corridor! What's that? Where are you, you sneaky slime? I'll catch you. Yes, I will.
There probably wasn't even a chance of me getting a 130 in the first place because of this cutscene.
Reflected in the mirror of Erised were Harry's parents, James and Lily Potter. Harry stared hungrily back as though hoping to fall right through the glass and reach them. He was startled when a voice sounded behind him. Harry turned slowly about. So you, like hundreds before you, have discovered the delights of the mirror of Erised, said Professor Dumbledore. He went on to explain that the mirror showed nothing more or nothing less than the deepest, most desperate desire of our hearts, but that it would give neither knowledge nor truth. The Mirror of Erised will be moved to a new home shortly, Dumbledore went on, adding ominously that if Harry ever came across it again, he would be prepared. But prepared for what? Thought Harry.
Filthy whelps gave us the slip, Mrs. Norris. I've locked the only door out of here for the sake of me nerves. Stay here and watch the library for a bit, my dear.
Pretty confident I'm gonna have sub 2 hours for this run, which is only because this I just need to not fuck up this part.
Where are you, you sneaky slime? I'll catch you. Yes, I will.
Okay. No, I did not. I didn't want to go down. It didn't even give me a choice. Apparently, I don't know how to walk. That was a bad spot. I don't know what I did there. There we go, I took off time.
Hermione, Ron, and Harry researched the secret of the Philosopher's Stone. It could produce the elixir of life, a potion that would make anyone immortal. No wonder someone's trying to get it. Anyone would want it, said Harry. Hermione suspected that the package Hagrid had taken from Gringotts contained the Philosopher's Stone. It was the Philosopher's Stone that was down the Forbidden Corridor, being guarded by whatever it was that had growled at them.
Snape's been acting very suspicious lately. He may be planning to steal the Philosopher's Stone.
But there's no way Snape would try anything while Dumbledore's around.
But Dumbledore left 10 minutes ago for the Ministry of Magic in London.
That must mean that tonight's the night. Let's go!
I probably shouldn't have a fluffy spoon.
What about Filch? He's always watching the Forbidden Corridor.
We'll just have to take our chances then.
It looks like Filch is somewhere else tonight.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna get rid of that split after this one.
Come on, let's go!
This way, Harry!
This is where the growling has been coming from.
Hear that? I don't think we should go in there.
But we've got to stop Snape. Go on, Harry. We're right behind you.
I'll try the flute. That might put Fluffy to sleep.
Do be careful.
I have no health, which is not good.
No, I don't.
Right. See you in a minute. I hope. It's okay. It's a soft landing. You can jump.
Come on, Harry.
If I get hit here, I'm probably dead.
I know what this is. It's a devil's snare.
Next time I'm gonna pay more attention in herbology.
Help! It's a devil's snare!
Try not to get too close to those tentacles.
Incendio!
Incendio!
Close, Harry.
This way, Harry.
You should say Harry more times.
You have to catch the key, Harry. Time to put your Quidditch skills to practice.
Good luck, Harry.
Not bad.
Well done, Harry. Let's see what this leaves.
But not amazing. Still not bad. I forgot to split a while. I didn't even realize I have a split for the key.
Oh, Ron, are you alright?
I've defeated most of the pieces, but I've been hurt. It's up to you now, Harry.
Harry, you have to be careful and avoid the pieces.
I think I'm gonna get rid of the chest, or maybe I'll just get rid of Key and Fluffy and have the chest.
Walk onto the board, Harry.
Oh no, I know what I'm gonna do.
Do be careful.
So I'm not going to split when I finish the chest, I'm going to split when I finish the potions, and then rename it to just the challenges. So in the room, I'm gonna try a quick strat to see if I can,
Oh no!
I don't think those stairs would work anyway.
Magical fire. Looks like you have to choose the right potion. Be careful, Harry. It could be poison. This one looks like it will help us through the fire. Watch closely and keep your eye on the correct potion. Then choose wisely.
That took way too long.
Here it goes again.
Confusing.
ridiculous.
Okay, I have 15 minutes to beat Voldemort.
You've got to find Snape on your own. I'll go back and help Ron. Good luck, Harry.
Oh, I thought...
I wondered whether I'd be meeting you here, Potter. I suppose you were expecting someone else. Well, it's me, scared, stuttering Professor Quirrell. You're far too inquisitive to remain among the living.
Flipendo! 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 Flipendo!
Why would you get on that? I'm gonna YOLO this jump. Got it.
Curses, Potter! You will not succeed again.
Let's do this.
Give me the stone.
Let me speak to him face to face.
Master, you're not strong enough.
I have strength enough for this.
Kill him.
know how to play this. Two more hits. Nice. I'm really happy with that. That was really close too.
Dumbledore smiled. What happened down in the dungeons between yourself and Professor Quirrell is a complete secret, he said. So naturally,
thank you. The school knows. That was my first full run because in my last run my game crashed halfway through, which was not fun.
Dumbledore nodded, sharing his concern.
So I am about 9 minutes off, 8 minutes off of world record, and I know I could save at least 2 in my next run from just being stupid.
Harry made his way down to the end of the year feast alone. The great hall was decked out in green.
I'm gonna watch the end and then I'm going to go. Because I don't have time for another run.
When Harry entered, there was a sudden hush. He took a seat between Ron and Hermione, trying to ignore the stares of the other students. The House Cup, announced Dumbledore, is awarded to the team with the most house points. At the moment, that would seem to be Slytherin. A storm of cheering and stamping broke out from the Slytherin table. However, continued Dumbledore, in recognition of Mr. Harry Potter's pure nerve and outstanding courage, I award Gryffindor 60 points.
That's almost 100.
Harry's table erupted with cheers and applause. The additional point had won the House Cup for Gryffindor.
Yeah, I mean, that's how most people start out speedrunning. You find a game that you really like, and then you play it. But there actually are quite a few people who... Well, there's only like a few that play this game, but the 3 good Harry Potter PC games are actually surprisingly popular among the speedrunning community. And I'm hoping to get more viewers soon. I am pretty new at speedrunning. Been going for 2 months now. But yeah, the key is to start with a game that you really enjoy. And I really enjoyed Chamber of Secrets, and it's basically like this game. So, that and we're doing a big trilogy race soon of the first 3 games. So I have to learn this and Prisoner of Azkaban. Thank you for watching, Felpa, and I don't know if anyone else was even here. So yeah, I'm gonna go. Thanks again for watching.